हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंटरफेरेंस एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक कंपैटिबिलिटी एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम। द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम इज द रेंज ऑफ ऑल पॉसिबल फ्रीक्वेंसीज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन। यू कैन व्यू हियर द डायग्राम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम। There are different wavelengths and different frequencies which are used for different applications. Electromagnetic interference, which is abbreviated as EMI, electromagnetic interference is disturbance that affect an electrical circuit due to either electromagnetic induction or radiation emitted from an internal or external source. These disturbances may interrupt, obstruct, or degrade, as well as limit the effective performance of a circuit or an equipment. The source may be any object. It can be artificial or natural. EMI can be intentionally used for radio jamming, as in some forms of electronic warfare, or can occur unintentionally as a result of spurious emissions. Have you ever experienced any EMI effect in your daily life? Please pause this video, think, and write down an answer on the paper before going to the next slide. You must have experienced this. I think now you are ready with your answer. Now we'll continue with EMI sources. There are two main types of EMI sources. It can be natural or man-made. Some of the examples of natural EMI sources are terrestrial, extraterrestrial. The terrestrial sources can be thunderstorms, lightning discharges, etc. Some of the extraterrestrial sources are sun disturbed and quiet cosmic noise from the stars. The man-made EMI sources. These are the examples of man-made EMI sources, such as generation equipments, transmission equipments like pickup and re-radiation, and faulty insulations, transformers, etc. Distribution equipments like faulty transformers, wiring, insulation, poor grounding, pickup and re-radiation. All electronic communication devices such as police radio, radars, cellular and mobile communication devices, satellite communication, point-to-point communication, TV and radio. Some of the other sources are industrial machines, cranes, trucks, milling machines, printing presses, punch presses, office and business machines, computers, cash registers, electronic typewriters, photocopiers, etc. Some other sources are welding machines, heaters, arc welders, RF stabilized welders, induction heaters, transporters, elevators, escalators, conveyor belts, power tools, drilling machines, grinders, mixers, and saws. Some appliances such as air conditioners, refrigerators, microwave ovens, vacuum cleaners, electric lawn mowers, etc. Engines, vehicles, automobiles, aircrafts, tanks, trucks, tractors, etc. Some of the tools such as auxiliary generators, lawn mowers, portable saws, some light sources such as neon light, RF excited gas displays, fluorescent lamps, etc. These are the equipments. Some medical equipments are also the sources of EMI as listed here. Some nuclear submarines and power stations can also cause electromagnetic interference. The sum of the EMI themes are listed below, such as communication receivers, microprocessors, computers, industrial controls, medical equipment, household appliances, and living beings. These are the examples of commonly experienced electromagnetic effects in our daily life. Lightning. Sometimes we have seen that TV sets are damaged by a main line. Sometimes we have also heard noise in the car radio. Ignition can also create disturbances. 50 Hz from mains to be heard in other audio devices. Disturbance while mobile phone is placed near microphone. Interference during landline call if there is an incoming call on mobile phone placed near landline phone. Disturbance on TV sets or computer monitors by ordinary loudspeakers. If you have good quality speakers, then EMI effect will be less. Basic components of EMI occurrences: source, which will emit the interference, transfer, coupling path, a wired or wireless, receptor, which will be generally a victim of EMI effect. This is a diagram of EMI coupling mechanisms. You can see source, then channel and victim. It can be radiative or conductive. You can see from the diagram. EMI is coupled in two ways, as I have already said. One, by conduction. In this case, interference is routed along power supply and signal lines. Two, by radiation. In this case, an interference is coupled through radiation from wires and antennas. It will be through wireless channel. EMI control techniques at source. Some of the important points to reduce or control EMI are as follows: proper grounding, filtering of electromagnetic interference, and PCB layout. Introduction to EMC. Electromagnetic compatibility is the ability of apparatus to function satisfactorily in its electromagnetic environment without introducing intolerable electromagnetic disturbance to other apparatus in that environment. So, EMC is a controlling mechanism to protect against EMI effects. A system is said to be electromagnetically compatible if it follows following requirements. The first requirement is it does not cause interference with other system. The second requirement is it is not susceptible to emissions from other systems. And the third and most important requirement is it does not cause interference with itself. This electromagnetic compatibility of an equipment or device can be tested using anechoic chambers and GTEM cells. Thank you so much for being patient listeners.